All right, what's up, everybody? Welcome to a brand new series on the channel, TimeSplitters 2. My name is Raven from the Sky. Let's do this.
Out of the darkness, they came with a hateful will to destroy humanity. We fought long and hard, but now we are lost, for they have taken their evil war into our past. Traveling through time, they have sown corruption, unraveling the fabric of our history. Our last chance is to strike back, seize the time crystals, and turn their twisted weapon against them. The fight for survival has begun.
Alpha Base, do you copy? Over.
Roger. You are clear to go. Proceed as planned, and good luck.
Docking bay's clear.
Go!
You've got a patrol on level 2. Incoming! On your right!
Yeah!
Good work! We've detected a power surge on the bridge.
Looks like we're too late. You're already moving the crystals.
Cover me. I'm going in. Good. Watch out.
You go after them.
Right.
I'll hold them off here. Hey.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Thanks.
All right. Good old General Cortez. We'll play it on that. 1990 Siberia. Siberia Oblast Dam. A secret research facility under a Siberian dam has unearthed preserved organic specimens, which are over 10,000 years old. Following a number of mysterious incidents, the original scientific team has left the site, and a Russian military garrison has been assigned to the excavation project. Intelligence has revealed that the military's attempts to develop biological weaponry from the finds have had dreadful results. They must not be allowed to continue this research. Although biohazard cleanup forces are on their way, there is an opportunity to investigate the base and destroy the samples and research records before they arrive. The base is currently under lockdown. The perimeter guards are jumpy and the automated security system has been engaged. Avoid the cameras if necessary. They can be switched off or destroyed. Cutting off the communication uplink should buy some time to explore the base more fully. Man, I remember I was in middle school. No. Yeah, I was in middle school when this came out. I remember playing this, man, back then as a kid.
Nicholas, shh. We shouldn't be in the research center without security clearance.
I'm telling you, I heard gunshots.
They're killers if they find out. Come on, coward.
And haven't played it since then. But I loved it. This was before the online gaming surge, I should say. The internet was around back then. I didn't have it.
The light.
But
stupid torch. Does nothing.
This back when
work.
Like companies were, you know, shelling out games like every year. Sometimes multiple games a year. You had more so local multiplayer because online gaming wasn't a thing yet. Oh my. I remember, I think Future Perfect had online, because by then online started creeping up, you know, with the success of Halo 2 and stuff like that, Battlefield, Counter-Strike,
settle down to me now.
And then sometimes, like, something, I was having issues with my disk drive on my PS2. So sometimes TimeSplitters would work, sometimes it wouldn't. Or sometimes it would freeze up. It was just crazy. So this is an absolute blast to play through this again. I loved TimeSplitters. I really had issues with Future Perfect. That wouldn't work. It took forever to try to get that to work. I remember I had bought it used. I forgot what store. It wasn't GameStop. It was one of them like other game stores, like mom and pop ones. I don't know. But it wasn't a chain, like a mainstream, like GameStop or Best Buy. I had bought it used and I had bought a bad copy and so they're trying to get it to work. I'm playing horribly. Forgot the controls. They weren't that great compared to games of today's age, day and age. You know what this game reminded me of back then and still does? The GoldenEye. It's almost like it was their answer to it. PlayStation and, of course, Xbox. I had this for the PS2, though, back then. I didn't even have an Xbox original until, like, 2004. It had already been out for 3 years. Then you had the arcade mode and stuff that let you do like missions, and then you could map maker, you can make your own like missions and stuff like that. It's crazy.
Thank you.
All right, that ends him. Let's go. There is no power. I can't remember how many guards were in here. I remember the level, but I can't remember. It's been so long, man. 2002, and I don't think I played TimeSplitters that year it came out. I think I played it the following year. Like 2003, I think I played this. But I remember that's when it came out, around like 2002. And Future Perfect came out like early 2005. All right, let's go. GoldenEye wasn't even online. That was so much fun, dude. And I can't even remember. Did they ever remake that and made it to where you could play it online on the Xbox Live Arcade? I can't remember. Oh, my God. You know, with the... You know that rare replay or whatever it's called? I cannot remember. You know what, those arcade cabinets they were released for the marketplace. I don't know, it's been so long, so many years, so many games. Correct me if I'm wrong though. Like this game was ahead of its time. And then they had another game, it was sort of like a spinoff. Then it was like, what was it called? Second Sight. It had to do with psychic powers. That was really fun. I had that for the Xbox. I had that around like 2004, 2005. Y'all remember that? Second Sight. heard the gunshot. And the Conda card. Cartridge. Easter eggs. Those were in here, weren't they? Whoops. Oh, God. I just called the guards on myself. Can't remember if this auto save, you had to hard save. I think you auto saved.
Hey.
They already did. Specimens broke out. Oh, and I remember it was an arcade level. It was like a zombie outbreak. I got the crystal. I feel like they're gonna get up. See if I'm going the right way. Deactivate the communications dish, restore power, access the top of the dam. We have to shoot that dish. Flamethrower, though.
Thank you.
I need to destroy that darn container. Unless... File cabinets. What? Say burn the evidence. Do they mean the evidence up here? Destroy the camera, but the now I'm still going off. I think we can, hold on, we might have to deactivate it via the computer.
Thank you.
Still gotta deactivate that dish, so that means I have to go all the way back across. That's how I did it before. Let's see. Run! Not retrying. All right, ladies and gentlemen, thanks for watching. My name is Raven from the Sky. If you enjoyed the episode, drop a like and subscribe to the channel and the series grow. Take care, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.